You mentioned the Filipino mythical creatures.
I've got this idea, Netflix. I wrote the whole pilot na, and I'm gonna send it to you after this.
Check this out. What's up, Philippines? My name is Franco Mabanta, and welcome to The Stir. We can't help but root for individuals facing insurmountable odds. Like, imagine if Shaquille O'Neal joined a limbo competition. People would be mesmerized. And throughout our country's history, we have had plenty of underdogs to admire. From Lapu-Lapu bringing Magellan's journey to an abrupt end, to Henry C. turning his little shoe store into an empire, to Pia Wurtzbach conquering the universe. The refusal to crumble under the weight of adversity is embedded in our DNA, and for our dear viewers with their own mountains to conquer, to those looking for a lightning bolt of inspiration, here are our five favorite underdog stories. At number five, we have Designated Survivor. When the president, VP, and every member of Congress were blown to bits, Kiefer Sutherland's Tom Kirkman finds himself taking over the Oval Office. From Secretary of Housing and Urban Development to the most powerful man in the free world, I think it's safe to say that this ocean-sized leap has left him a little in over his head. That's like going from Quek Quek vendor to Michelin-rated Master Chef, or Tai Bo instructor to heavyweight contender, or in a totally non-personal case, lowly opinionated blogger to bona fide talk show host. Can you imagine? At number four, we have Love. Now, I'm so very happy they've launched season two, as this is currently my favorite comedy on Netflix. It can be said that Gus Cruikshank isn't a shining star in LA's galaxy of glamour. Beyond that, he's about as edgy as a bowl of plain oatmeal and needs a metaphorical Sherpa to carry all his emotional baggage. Despite these obstructions, he gets together with Mickey Dobbs, who, with all due respect, is completely out of his league. Like, the two of them are in completely different leagues, in completely different sports, in completely different countries. Kudos to you, Gus. Kudos to you.
Maybe we could pretend like nothing happened and see if anyone notices.
That's my whole philosophy in life.
At number three, we have 3%. The first original Brazilian series on Netflix, 3% is a dystopian tale about class divide. Most of the world is stuck in the inland, which is so sunken in poverty. Those talking heads in the UNICEF ads look at them and go, "Yo, how much you need?" But that isn't the end of the tale. There's something called the process, where people are given a chance to migrate to the virtual paradise that is the offshore. Protagonist Michelle, without anyone or anything to lose, has a chance to make it through. Unfortunately for her, only 3% do. Much like my jokes. And that's being generous. No, seriously, I mean, you guys keep cutting all of my jokes. You guys keep cutting me. At number two, we got Trevor Noah, Afraid of the Dark. Born to a Swiss father and a South African mother in Johannesburg during the apartheid, Trevor Noah was, as he describes it, born a crime. Law forbade him to even be seen in public with his parents. Caught between races, he used that life as a perpetual outsider to birth tack-sharp material on racial identity. Trevor has gone against the odds and just released his 9th comedy special, and that's in between his day job as host of The Daily Show. Jealous? Me? Not at all. Maybe a little.
I love accents because I'm always impressed by how much power they have over us. The Russians, the most feared people on the planet. Even if they say nice things, it still sounds menacing and dangerous. Yeah, fluffy rabbits and teddy bears. Happy Valentine's Day.
And finally, at number one, we have Barry. This may be unfathomable now, but there was a time when Barack Obama was deemed uncool. I know, I could barely picture it either, but it's true. Barry captures that pre-POTUS period when he first arrives in Columbia University in 1981. In this biopic, Barry deals with the uncertainty of biracial identity and the tension of a biracial relationship. The film is a prelude to what might be the greatest underdog story of the last century, and for that, Barry gets our vote as number one. Speaking of underdogs, today we have a man who made a trillion videos before his first one got noticed, and is now the biggest male YouTuber in the history of the Philippines. Come sit with us. Mikey Bustos is here.
What's going on, Franco?
Finally get to meet you.
Yeah, it's
finally
great.
Get to meet you.
I heard a lot about you.
I heard a lot about you too, sir. Mm. So you know what I find incredibly admirable is your perseverance. You created a zillion videos before your first one got noticed, and now you are on this very unique trajectory that really I think no one could have predicted.
Yeah. I certainly didn't predict it. I actually
started entertainment in Canada through TV.
Mm-hmm.
So I was part of the whole traditional media. If I'm going to make it in entertainment, I've got to launch myself in TV, be in movies, make music videos for, you know, all of those TV channels. I was a finalist on Canadian Idol. I placed 8th in the competition, and I thought my career was set. You know, I had a gold record from it. I had a contract with BMG. I just thought it was cream from there. And then I learned later that it's actually pretty hard to maintain a career.
It wasn't the case.
It wasn't the case, you know, and I was jumping from management to management. And I just got kind of so tired of having a manager introduce me to the world that I decided, hey, why don't I just take the matters into my own hands, be more proactive, and introduce myself to the world.
You know, so, and that's what the internet does, right?
That's what it does. So I started creating one video every single day. Back then, this was 2011. All the major, I guess, people blowing up at that time, Justin Bieber, Arnel Pineda, Charisse Pempenko, they were all being discovered on YouTube. So I said, hey, maybe I can introduce my music on YouTube. So I started uploading a video every single day, starting January 1st, 2011. And I uploaded videos of me singing, covers, BTS performances, and then random skits too. So I'll never forget the date. It was February 25th. I was like, what can I do today? I don't feel like singing.
And it's a revolution.
Yeah, I was like, you know what? My parents. I'm going to do a video copying the way my parents speak.
Okay.
And it was called the Filipino Accent Tutorial. And I put on the barong and I wrote my script and filmed it. And I've never done comedy, ever. This was just like an experiment. And it blew up. It just completely defined my career from then on. So if there was a video that really started it all, it was that one.
Many of us Filipinos have Spanish last names, like Bustos. My full name is Michael John Yadanto Mangil Pestaño Bustos. Try saying that 5 times.
There's this new Netflix show that's called Haters Back Off.
Yes! Anyone from the YouTube universe knows who Miranda Sings is. She's actually a singer, a performer, and then she's got this character that she created on YouTube that went super popular.
Oh, Danny Boom. The pipes are calling.
I kind of identify with that. Like, I almost feel like I'm the male Filipino version of Miranda Sings.
I am Super Pinoy Boy.
I mean, I sing and I perform, but also there's this character that I've created that people have identified with, right? And so it's really kind of interesting having this dual personality. Again, I feel like Pinoy Boy is very real.
Yeah.
And to the point where I know what Pinoy Boy wants and what he doesn't like, what he would do, what he wouldn't. Or I almost feel like Pinoy Boy lives inside me. I'm just channeling a different facet.
I see. Yeah. What a trip it is, because she created this personality that got so, so famous that Netflix said, we're going to pick this character up and create an entire show around her.
Is the web necessary?
Yes, Mom, the internet is necessary. All the most famous people in the world started off on the internet. Justin Bieber, Susan Boyle, that cat that fell off the table when it got scared.
I think you're better than all those people.
And the cat?
Hey, you know what one of my favorite videos of yours is? Is that one where you're doing a parody of all the Filipino monsters?
Oh, yes.
That was super funny.
Mythical creatures rap.
The tikbalang and the thing. Yeah. And you were rapping about all these different kinds of monsters.
Yes, white lady, tikbalang, white lady, even the serena, the mermaid.
Watch where you're stepping, because I am a duende. I also go by elf, dwarf, goblin, puede.
I hear that you're a fan of Drew Barrymore's zombie character.
Yeah, Santa Clarita Diet. I really want to watch the entire series and like do a complete marathon of that show.
I can cook that for you, sweetheart.
I'm fine.
First of all, I'm a fan of Drew Barrymore, like ever since E.T. Mm-hmm. She's great, and I think she's a great comedian. And I also like the fact that you're laughing about something that's kind of dark, right? I'm a fan of writing and script and positioning of story, so which is what we do in our videos too. So these are things that I kind of really notice.
She is dead and also undead.
Zombie?
I don't like that word. I think it's inherently negative.
I don't like it either.
Well, let's not use it.
Another show I really want to start watching is Black Mirror. Gosh, because I'm also a science and technology guy.
Okay.
And again, I like the dark stuff. Because a lot of the stuff that we work on is funny and light.
Yeah.
Right? So when I take a break from that, I want to watch the kind of dark thriller and twisted stuff. Where you watch it and you're kind of like, oh, what did I just watch? My dream right now Netflix people, are you listening? is to have Philippine-based content. We are such great creators, right? Yeah. We Filipinos, we love to entertain. We create great movies. And hopefully one day, Netflix Asia picks up some of our shows to broadcast here locally and to other nations. I actually have an idea.
Really? Pitch it, please.
Speaking of which, you mentioned the Filipino mythical creatures.
Okay.
I've got this idea. Netflix, I wrote the whole pilot na, and I'm going to send it to you after this. It's called Myth Philippines. The whole idea is mythical creatures living in modern-day Manila. Yeah, social commentary. So who do I send it to? Netflix people, are you here?
We'll send your fax number or something.
Okay, yeah. Great.
You are a fascinating character, and I'm so happy we finally met, man.
Thank you.
Awesome
Franco,
stuff.
Same here.
Thank you so
it's
much,
Mikey. It's a pleasure.
Mikey. Pleasure, pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, the awesome Mikey Bustos. Hey everybody, please subscribe to Netflix Philippines on YouTube for exclusive previews, celebrity guests, and our take on the hottest Pinoy topics.